We have companies that are trying to block the solar adoption rooftop, so to speak. So obviously the transition to moving away to fossil fuel to sustain our economy, our businesses is, finding ways like the electric vehicle adoption. And now we have, solar rooftop adoption. But the thing here is there are companies, especially the utilities, have a vested interest that this does not push through. And let's see here. Yeah, so as I mentioned, so there are interest groups, special interest group, weird name that they call it, are trying to find a way to stop the growth of rooftop solar panels here. And according to the USPIRG or Education Fund, and also the Environment America Research and Policy Center, obviously, it makes sense, especially for locations that is there's full of sunlight that you could take advantage. So it makes sense to implement solar panels in your rooftop so that you can take advantage. Now, obviously, cost is a main hurdle in terms of each solar panels, how much it costs. But if you live in Arizona or in Utah, where there's plenty of sunlight whole year round, then you need to take advantage. Obviously, the initial upfront cost will be expensive, but in the long run, you don't rely as much if you're off grid, so to speak, here. And there were reports or case studies from all over the United States, and I think they can be applied to other countries as well, depending on the location here. There are strategies that promotes pro-fusel fossil fuel lobbying groups that are adopted by many utilities now, which is kind of ironic. Those same companies that conducted the study are now against it. Anyway, so that includes fixed rate charges on rooftop solar, or putting restrictions on or killing net metering programs that ensure solar panel owners receive fair compensation for the clean energy they supply to the electric grid. Now, obviously, those groups have significant clout in terms of, lobbying groups with corresponding politicians in their particular cities or even particular states here. And whether should they be granted or, halt the progression of solar adoption here, it's up to the politicians here to make a stand here. Obviously, if you want to push your agenda, and if this is what the citizens want, then you should go on with it. And obviously, if you're the utilities, then you need to evolve your business model because it will have a long-term impact in their business model that utilities like Meralco that we have here would not be a viable business in the next decade or even century here if the country is really dead set on moving away towards fossil fuel reliance here. And obviously it's up to the state or the lawmakers to promote and even defend policies that support growth of rooftop solar panels and speed of national transition towards 100 renewable energy. I think any countries or states should be looking at this tremendously now. Obviously, the adoption of solar panels is a case-to-case basis depending on your location here. Obviously, if it's cloudy in your area or it tends to more often rain than have sunlight there, then it won't make sense. That's why you look for alternative ways to find alternative ways to replace reliance on fossil fuel or electricity here. So you could use hydro is one, wind is another, then you have solar as another one, and then you have now EV vehicles being adopted here. Now, how fast can we adapt it for the rest of the world? We don't know, so we'll see.